Hey everyone, this is future editor Lena here, and I just wanted to say that I filmed this video 3 or 4 days ago, and I have had a change of heart, so I will update you guys. This is old. I worked really hard on this video, so I don't want to just like not upload it, but there will be a part three because I have matured in the last 4 days. Okay. Hey lovelies, thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new here, hi, my name's Lena. I do have a secondary channel where I talk more about family stuff, deeper into spirituality, pregnancy, birthday parties, stuff like that. So if that interests you, please go subscribe to Real Honest Mama. I'll have it in the description box below. I have also created a baby registry, so if you would like to buy something for my baby, I will have that down below as well. I also created a GoFundMe, so if you don't feel comfortable buying something and you'd rather just donate a dollar or two, that would be appreciated as well. All of that will be down in the description box below. Without further ado, let's get into the video. I think we left off where we officially all became together, became a throuple, and the night that we went on a date, so all of that great stuff happened, right? Looking back, I really feel that I went on this date with the intentions of having fun, meeting a girl, doing the whole girlfriend thing, like a first date. I think she went on that date to meet the other woman.
Am I right? Oh, am I right?
I don't think she was thinking, let's be together, let's be girlfriends. I don't think that she really wanted to be together. As things progressed, I started going over to Tanya's house a lot. It got so bad that my mom would be like, hey, like, where are you? Because I wouldn't be coming home after work. So I kind of had to like stop doing what I was doing as much. And that did kind of put like a strain on all of our relationship as a three, because we were still trying to get to know each other. You know, when you're first starting to learn someone, you want to be around them all the time. Like, you want to know everything and you want to just have fun and do things together. And that's what we were trying to do. But then that happened. So I kind of had to like rearrange certain things. So we had to actually start planning dates. So we actually went to the park a few times. We went to the zoo. When we went to the zoo, it was so awkward. I felt like I could not be myself because Tanya was being a Debbie Downer. And I don't even know how to express it because it wasn't verbal. But it was just her entire vibe, and Mans noticed it too. When we all left, I had to leap to go get my daughter from daycare. So they were gonna head off and do something together, and then I was gonna go my separate way. Well, I wanted to kiss Mans goodbye. At this point, I hadn't really kissed Tanya. She just seemed like she didn't wanna kiss me, or that she was shy, or I was just trying to let her figure things out and come on to me. So I hadn't kissed her outside of sex. And at this moment, she made me feel that I could not kiss him because I wasn't kissing her. So from then point forward, I started kissing both of them, hey and bye. Let me just tell you, those kisses were sparkless as fuck. She was not kissing me, I was kissing her. There was nothing emotional attachment to it. It felt like a game. It felt like spin the bottle or something. Like it was a dare. Like it meant nothing. It really started to annoy me because I'm like, okay, are you not feeling me? First of all, I'm very open-minded, but let's be for real, Tanya was not my typical type of girl, if I'm gonna date a girl. But I gave it a chance because I liked her personality at first, and I thought she was cool, and I thought that she wanted this as much as I did, so that's kind of where I was with it. Everything else started to really piss me off because I felt like I lowered my standards for her, and she literally denied me. Who do you think you are? Like, do you know who I am? You know how many just actually want me in real life? She's not bi. Let me just throw that out there. If you're playing bisexual, grow up. Just please grow up. Been there, done that. At some point, if you know you don't like girls, you don't like girls. Like, why are you lying to yourself? Why are you lying to us? Why are you trying to do this? As days passed, I would go over and spend the night, and I would always show up, and it would be an awkward vibe in the room. And it was just silent. And I'm like, is this y'all's relationship? Like, are y'all normally silent with each other? Because I can't shut the fuck up. I talk all the time. I don't understand this, but I'm trying to. I felt like I was always coming in at the wrong time, or maybe they had just had an argument, but it was every single time I came over. Every single time. I kind of started feeling like Tanya was not feeling it, but I didn't have any hardcore proof. And Mance kept saying that she's just trying to figure stuff out. She's just going with the flow. She's just this, she's just that. So I was like, okay, like maybe this is just her personality. She's just boring as fuck. And I'm gonna have to start being my true self, even though she's the way that she is, because I can't mimic her personality or try to fit the mold, fit the vibe when it's not healthy for me, because that's not who I am. Things started getting serious. We were all in a position where we wanted to move out and we wanted to, you know, just have our own places. So we started house hunting because we thought, since we're all together, rent split three ways, groceries three ways, everything three ways would be so easy and everything would be so happy and fun. And so we started house hunting, all three of us. There were even times when me and Tanya went without mans, and it was fun. I will admit that looking at houses as a throuple was pretty fun. I never got there because we'll get into that in a second. Mans goes out of town because he had to visit his daughter. He's gone for about a week, I believe, but I still come over to hang out with Tanya one night after work. So I come over, she has like this setup for me with weed and alcohol and fun stuff, okay? So I was like, oh, like my girlfriend loves me. No, bitch. Anyway, I get so drunk. We never had sex, we never did anything like that because like I said, I didn't really feel that she was into that and I wasn't trying to come onto her first because I didn't want to make her feel uncomfortable. I don't want to be labeled like a rapist. I don't want to push boundaries. And apparently she felt some type of way about it. Whatever. Anywho, I think it was either that night or the next day when I woke up. I think it was when I woke up the next day. We were just talking and she was like, it really sucks that Mans is not going to be able to come back. He's not coming back. It's just going to be me and you. He gonna stay up there with his daughter? Like, what you mean he's not coming back? She goes, yeah, well, not like that. He just can't come back here. Does he know that he's not going to have a place to come back to? Like, and why? Like, what is going on? You know, I'm completely lost. She proceeds to say how there's stuff going on with her roommates and they don't want him here. I looked her in her face and I said, well, is he helping you? Is he helping you pay rent? Is he helping you pay for things? Is he doing stuff around the house? And she said, yes. And I was like, are you paying your half of the rent and doing things as well around here? She said, yes. I was like, so you have a say-so in this. I mean, just because your roommates don't like him for whatever reason doesn't mean that he can't sleep here. She was like, well, it's just too much and yeah, he's just not gonna be able to come back. Grow some fucking balls, bitch. That conversation made me want to slap her in the face, and then she begged me not to tell him. Bitch, I told him, because you were just gonna like expect him to drive 8 hours back and have nowhere to be? That makes no sense. You have a voice. If you live somewhere and you have roommates and your boyfriend is staying with you and helping you pay, helping do stuff around the house, why is it a big deal? These roommates are acting like he's a serial killer, like he's done something actually wrong, like he's one of the other roommates. I was thinking all this other crazy stuff because I'm like, why are y'all kicking him out if he hasn't done anything? Turns out the roommates just didn't like that we were all together, that we were all a throuple. Why? Because Tanya was going back and telling them stuff and complaining and probably talking crap about me, about being the other woman, and not actually wanting to be all together. That is why her roommates felt so strongly about it. Because otherwise, why would these random roommates give a fuck about a healthy relationship that we have going on? That has nothing to do with bills, that has nothing to do with helping around the house, it has nothing to do with them at all. Tell me. Basically, he had to go live with some friends. Excuse me. Oh, Lord. Let me drink some water. And he was still trying to help her pay the rent, y'all. I said, no, sir. No, you're not gonna keep helping her pay for stuff if you're not living there, because she kicked your ass out for no reason. I became pregnant after all of us had slept together one night. I wanted to tell her, but he didn't want me to in the moment, because I guess they had already had a conversation prior to us all being together that if I was to get pregnant first, that she was gonna leave him and she was gonna act all crazy. Is it a game? Like, do you think being pregnant is a game? Do you think it's a competition? Because it's not. These are children being brought into the world. Grow the fuck up. So she was talking about April Fools because that was that time of the year. And she was like, let's tell Mans that I'm pregnant. I was like, oh, well, I think I may actually be. And she was like, really? How do you know? I'm about to take a test. So I told her that it was positive and she just ghosted me. Didn't break up with me. Didn't say anything. Didn't ask if I was okay. Didn't congratulate me. Didn't comfort me. Just ghosted me.
Hey, hey, you never loved me.
And then she went the fuck off on Mans and broke up with him because she wanted to be pregnant first. Like, we're playing house. You know what it's like to be pregnant. Do you know what it is to bring a child into this world? Why are you playing right now? This is a serious matter. And I've forgiven her, but that ship has sailed, bitch. And now guess what? Now guess what? Tanya's pregnant too. Yeah. And honestly, it pissed me off because she messaged me asking if we could talk and sent like the angel face emoji. Like it's a game. Then apparently Mans was having a bad day and she brings the announcement up to him as if it was gonna cure his bad day. So we're already having financial problems. You've kicked him out of your house. He's damn near homeless. And you think a baby announcement is gonna make someone's day better after I'm already pregnant? And he already has another child? Are you psychotic? You think it's all giddy giddy, funny funny, haha. It's not fucking funny. I'm not saying you can't be happy. It is a celebration. Bringing a baby into this world is magical. But to sit there and be like, I think we should talk. Bitch, I haven't talked to you in months because I don't fuck with you because you ghosted me and you acted like you were bisexual even though you weren't, and I cannot respect that at all. I told her, best of luck to you, bitch, but I couldn't care less if you're pregnant or not. Congratulations. Hope that you know your entire world is about to turn right the upside down. And I'm even mad that I know about it because, yes, we are a polyamorous couple. I'm with him, she's with him, but me and her are not together. So I don't feel that I needed to know that information because I'm not with her. We're not girlfriends. Our kids are finna be siblings, and that shit pisses me off. And I'm really trying to be a mom, and I'm trying to be an adult and mature. But deep down, I want to be like, fuck that.
I don't fuck with you.
Like, no, my kid is not going to be your kid's sibling. Biologically, yes, but no, because you're childish and immature, and look how you treated me. I just can't treat kids that way. Kids ain't got nothing to do with it. These children will have nothing to do with me and Tanya's problems, so I'm gonna have to grow the fuck up and let it go just for the kids. But when the kids aren't around, bitch, don't talk to me. Don't talk to me. Do not talk to me. Because you ghosted me and you pretended to be bi. You could have cut it off right then when we went on our first date. You could have said it was very nice to meet you. I personally don't want to be with a girl. We can have fun, we can drink, we can smoke, we can fuck, but I do not want to be in a relationship with you, Alina. And I would have perfectly understood, but she doesn't stand her ground. She's very timid. She's fucking boring as hell. I just can't vibe with it. I can't. It pissed me off that I even know this information because it's not affecting me. Unless they're telling me this because it will affect me. Is it gonna fuck up my baby shower? Yes or no? If not, I don't care. I chose this life. I chose to be in a polyamorous relationship. Me and the girl didn't work out. We broke up. We all know that we're having unprotected sex. I'm already knowing all of this. So I'm not mad that she's pregnant. I'm mad that she's acting like it's a joke, like it's a game, like, oh yay, this is gonna make someone's day better. I can't even be fully excited for mine, for myself, because all I can think about is money, money, money. Like, we're all in a hole right now, and she thinks it's a joke. And I don't think it's funny, and I don't think it's cute. If you wanna celebrate your little moments in silence to yourself with him, fine. But you do not need to include me because, quite frankly, bitch, I don't care. And you know what? I could say so many hateful, mean things, but honestly, I hope and pray that you have a safe, healthy pregnancy. It's your first pregnancy? What did you want? Did you want advice for me? Like, what was your point in texting me? And she already bought a onesie and shit, and she's only 4 weeks pregnant. Like, you really think this is a game? Ghosted me and led me on. And now you want me to fuck with you just because you're pregnant. You got a lot of growing up to do, sis. You have, whoo! First of all, this whole poly thing was my idea. I said it out loud first. I'm the one who brought it to the table. So I don't want anyone to feel bad for me because I chose this and I wanted this. And I actually wanted a relationship with her, but she did not want a relationship with me. And now I especially don't give two fucks about what she has going on. Of course, I don't want anything bad to happen to these babies. Of course. Of course, I'm not gonna be no evil ass mom. Of course, I'm gonna be a good ass mom. I'm not gonna let nothing happen to your child, just like I would hope you wouldn't let nothing happen to mine, but I don't fuck with you. Yep, that's the end of the story. Hope you guys enjoyed it. That is how I met my ex-girlfriend, and I'm in shock. It's about to be a long road ahead. It really is. If you guys are interested in stories like this one, please stay tuned for the next video, and I'll see you guys then. Love you so very much. Bye.